Hello everyone and welcome to our channel Divine Classes Shimla. Today we will be covering part 2 of District Bilaspur in our district wise map analysis series of Himachal Pradesh. Friends, part 2 is all about the history of Bilaspur, which starts from the founder of the state, Raja Bichat, who found an idol of goddess Durga beneath a stone slab. He built a fort and named it Kot Kehlu and also constructed the Naina Devi temple for the idol. After Bichat came Raja Kehlchand. He was sixth descendant of ruling family, and in many books you will find that he was a person who built Kot Kehlu, but actually it was built by Bichat. After Raja Kehlchand came Raja Ajit Chand, who founded the ruling dynasty of Hindur, jisko aaj aap Nalagarh ke naam se jante hain, and he handed over this dynasty to his brother Suchet Chand. After Ajit Chand came Megh Chand, who was forced by the people to leave the state, and he got asylum in Kullu, though he regained the lost kingdom with the help of Delhi Sultan Shamshu-ud-Din Altutmush. After him came Raja Abhisan Chand. He was ruling at the time of Sikandar Lodi. He won many battles against Tatar Khan Amir. After Abhisan Chand came Raja Sampurna Chand. He was killed by his brother Ratan Chand. It is very important for our study because this was a rare case in Hindu to kill a brother for the throne. Ratan Chand had a long reign, had a good relation with the Delhi Sultans. After him came Raja Gyan Chand or Ayam Chand in 1570 AD. He was ruling at the time of Akbar. He adopted Islam. His tomb is still there at Kiratpur in Punjab. He had three sons, Bik Chand, the elder son. He remained a Hindu, but younger son Ram Chand and Bhima Chand also converted to Islam. Bik Chand married to the daughter of Raja Trilok Chand of Kangra. Raja Bich Chand left his throne to Sultan Chand after ruling for 20 years. After him came Raja Kalyan Chand, who married to the daughter of Raja of Suket, Raja Shyam Saran Sen. He built fort on the border of Hindur, which caused war between two states. In this battle, Raja of Hindur was killed. Suket Raja and Kalyan Chand were badly wounded and died at a place called Kalyan Chandi Dwari while returning to Bilaspur. After him came Raja Tara Chand, who is famous for building Taragarh Fort in Hindur. After him was Raja Deep Chand from 1650 to 1656. He shifted the residence of ruling family from Sunhani, a place near present-day Jhanduta, to new place Dholra on the left bank of river Satluj. Traditionally, it is called Vyas Gufa. He founded the town Bilaspur. He changed the salute Jai Deva to Raja, Jai to Miani, and Ram Ram to Ranas. He was poisoned at Nadaun by Raja of Kangra, Chandrabhan Chand. During the same time, Anandpur Sahib was founded in June 1665 by the 9th Sikh Guru, Guru Tegh Bahadur. He got three villages from Rani of Kehlur. He previously lived in Kiratpur, but given the disputes with Ram Rai, he moved to the village in Makhowal. He named it Chak Nanaki after his mother. In 1675, Guru Tegh Bahadur was tortured and beheaded for refusing to convert to Islam under the orders of the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb. A martyrdom that led Sikhs to rename the town to Anandpur and crown his son Gobind Das as his successor and famous as Guru Gobind Singh. Wapis aate hai Bilaspur ki history pe. At this time came Raja Bhim Chand in 1667. He was minor when his father Deep Chand died. He fought battle with his wazir Manak Chand, brother of Deep Chand, who was dismissed by Raja, by Rajmata Jalal Devi from the post of wazir. Now Bhim Chand was supported by Sidh Sen of Mandi. Raja Deep Chand has two ranis, one from Mandi named Jalal Devi and other from Kullu named Kumkum Devi. Now there is a rumor that Mandiali Rani wants to get the daughter of Kulluvi Rani married to her brother. That was Raja of Mandi. But Rani Kumkum, who was from Kullu, never agreed to his proposal, nor she has idea of this rumor. So she, along with her daughter, committed self-immolation in the state palace itself. When Raj Parivar knew of this tragedy, they felt shocked and pained. They built a temple in the memory of Rani and her daughter. Bhim Chand fought two battles with Guru Gobind Singh between 1682 to 1685, and the cause of two wars was White Elephant of Guru that was demanded by Raja Bhim Chand. He lost the battle and spent end of his life as Fakir. After him came Raja Ajmer Chand, who is famous for a fort on the border of Hindur called Ajmergarh. After him came Raja Devi Chand. During his time, a revolt took place in the neighboring state of Nalagarh, where Raja Man Chand and his son were killed. Gaje Singh was installed as a new king of Hindur by Raja Devi Chand. He built the fort Bhamaikot and gave Ramgarh fort to Hindur. After him came Mahan Chand. He was 6 years old when his father Devi Chand died. Administration remained under Ramu Wazir, who died in 1785. After him, Raja Sansar Chand of Kangra, he invaded Kahilur in 1795 and occupied Chauki Hatwar. Raja Dharam Prakash of Sirmaur, who came to help Kahilur on the request of Rani, got killed. Sansar Chand built fort on Dhar Jhanjhar in Bilaspur and called it Chhatepur. During his reign, Gurkhas emerged as great power. Their headquarter was at Gadwal. Raja Mahan Chand invited Amar Singh Thapa to help him against Kangra ruler Sansar Chand. In 1805, Sansar Chand was defeated by Gurkha's force under the command of Amar Singh Thapa at Mahal Moria, that is Hamirpur. So after Mahan Chand came Raja Khadak Chand for 15 years and lost his throne in a revolt which was led by his uncle Jagat Chand. Then came Raja Jagat Chand from 1839 to 1857. One of the two Ranis of Khadak Chand returned to Bilaspur from Sirmaur with army in order to get back the throne. Raja Jagat Chand at that time fled to Hindur. Later he restored as Raja with the help of political agents of Ambala and Raja Ram Saran Singh of Hindur. In 1850, Raja Jagat Chand left his throne in favour of his grandson. Then came Raja Hira Chand. He was the one who supported the Britishers during 1857 revolt. His period is known as Golden Age. He brought tax reforms and reduced taxes and started the revenue demand payable partly in cash in certain areas of the state. In 1882, he paid a visit to Shimla with his son Tikka Amar Chand. He developed some illness on the way to the state and died at Mahal. After him came Amar Chand, who transferred all the literary sources of the state in Devanagari Lipi. After him was Raja Bijay Chand from 1889 till 1902. Friends, this is a most important period for our studies because at this time, Raja Bijay Chand in 1889 brought reforms in judicial system, introduced the system of court fee and non-judicial stamps. These were also introduced for the first time. He constructed Rang Mahal Palace at Bilaspur and in the First World War, he extended all possible help to the British for which he was decorated with the title of KCIE, which is equivalent to the rank of a major. Then came the last ruler of Bilaspur, Raja Anand Chand, from 1928 to 1948. He succeeded the throne on February 1927. He passed an act to abolish Begar and child marriage by the act in 1942. He signed the instrument of accession to join Indian dominion. Bilaspur was made part C state on 15th August 1948. And on 12th October 1948, he was appointed the first Chief Commissioner of Part C State and continued up to 1st April 1949. Now the question is, who became the second Chief Commissioner? It was Srichand Chhabra. On 1st July 1954, Bilaspur was merged into Himachal as a new district. Raja Anand Chand remained Member of Constituent Assembly, Member of Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and Member of State Legislative Assembly. He also wrote a book entitled Bilaspur Past, Present and Future. He died in October 1983 in London. After him, his son Raja Kriti Chand became Raja in 1983 who died in 2013. Raja Subhendra Chand succeeded his father in 2013 and won the Bilaspur Palace. Shashi Vansh Vinod book and Chand Vansh Vilas are the two major sources of Bilaspur or the Kahilur history. Now here are some facts for Bilaspur district. Now we will be moving toward Chamba district in our next video. Till then, take care, be safe and study smart.